What's up, hungry ones? Welcome to Quarter Munchers. I'm Johnny.
I am the only match.
And there's a slidey door in front of us. Wonder where that's going.
Light doors.
Yeah, I thought this was the boss door. I was wrong. Easy mistake to make, though.
Yeah. So
I looked at my map literally like right before getting here and was like, there's a clear, like, big red skull on the map for where the boss is, and it's nowhere near here. And yet I was like, oh, this must be the boss door. That one's on me.
So.
Ah, fucking stupid-ass pole.
Instead, we have the Jedi Pizza Cats.
Dude, did you ever watch Samurai Pizza Cats?
Oh, yeah.
That show was a gift.
It's really, the Samurai Pizza Cats is great. Street Sharks was alright.
Street Sharks was trash. What are you talking about?
I didn't hate it. I mean, I was always very open-minded about the stuff that I watched anyway, but, like, I never really had a whole lot of, like, strong negative opinions about any, like, cartoons when I was a kid, except for Doug.
You didn't like Doug?
I didn't like Doug. I didn't like Doug back then. I can appreciate it now, but, like, when I watched it when I was a kid, it was like Doug was that awkward kid that I was. So like, I was and still am to a very large degree very escapist in my entertainment.
And I like to see your own life thrown back at your face in the mirror.
Right, and I like to see more of like you know what I wish my life was in some instances.
So than, you're telling like, me you wanted to be a shark that lived in a sewer.
Duh.
Dreams can come true, Johnny.
Who doesn't? I mean, that's that like that is a dream, right? That's living the dream.
I mean, you'd have to change your name to Slamu. Are you ready to make such a? I mean, first of all, have you even asked Suzanne about it?
Not really.
Slamu Denman.
Okay. I don't enter many tournaments nowadays, mostly because I run them and it's really hard to do one or the other. But if I enter any tournaments from now on, I'm entering as Slamu. It's fucking pure and simple.
Good old Slamu Denman. Living in the sewers, sharpening his teeth with files, fucking drafted a fin to his back. Look, Johnny, if you want to live this life, you got to make sacrifices.
Not nail files to the teeth. Oh, God.
Nail files? Try metal.
God. Fuck you, dude. Fuck.
80 grit.
There are, like,
bastard files.
I used to play, like, when I was in music school, I played a lot of classical guitar, which is very nail intensive. I had to use a nail file on my nails, and I am it is the worst feeling in the world. It's the worst sensation in the world. I hate the sound of it. I hate the
We have completed the octahedron.
Congratulations. God, now I have like also, the feeling of a nail file across my nails.
Think of it in your teeth.
That's also what I'm thinking of, because somebody mentioned that one day, and I literally, like, my entire body seized up like it is right now.
Also, look at this environmental storytelling. We got some fucking rotten corpses and some single pixels that are yellow, so I'm going to assume they're coins. These guys
Holy
are playing
shit,
poker.
It's... Yeah, it's the legendary dogs playing poker, like, 70 years later.
Yeah, or 10 years, because they're dogs. Dog years. Joke. We'll fix it in post. We'll Pro Tools it.
I need to learn when to take sips of my beverage, because that was not the right time.
Oh, did I get you?
You almost did. Like, I get a lot of suds with that.
It's one of my Jedi... Aw, jeez, I just destroyed the flowers on what I'm assuming is a grave. Whoops. But
wow,
it's my one
karma.
Weird... It's my one weird force power is knowing exactly when to tell a joke so it makes somebody choke on their drink.
Like, oh, I just swallowed a lot of air with that. So, like, you know when you swallow a lot of air with something that, like, bubbles up your throat and you're like, ah. Oh.
Yeah.
Plus, it's a very sudsy lager, so that doesn't help anything either.
Ah, good sudsy lager.
Yeah, we drink beer on this show. What of it?
I'm enjoying myself a nice Sierra Nevada Otravez.
Is that the Ghost?
Yeah, it's the Gosa.
That's right.
It is so goddamn delicious.
I gotta give sours another chance.
I'll admit, you know, I'll be the first to tell you, they're not for everybody, but they are very much for me.
I forget, like, the first one I had was at one of the bars around here was doing a tap takeover of Brooklyn. And yeah. They got, like, all, like, the super rare reserve Brooklyn stuff on tap.
Huh.
And one of them was a sour, and I remember I took one sip of it and went, nope.
Yeah, I mean, I guess two things about sours. One, they're not for everybody, and even me, I love sour beers, and I'm very picky about them. They're definitely, like, good ones and, like, bad ones. And there's different stuff that appeals to different people.
The good ones and bad ones can really speak to any sub. I almost call it genre of beer.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not the wrong way to say it, but.
Yeah, because like I like the Gosas and the Berliner Weisses. Stuff like that. But then there's other sours like Belgian triples and stuff that I'm just like, yeah, no thanks. Like, I like a really, like, acidic, fruity, like, citrusy kind of sour.
Yeah.
Not like, so I think much like the...
You were having something like a cherry gosa at one point, weren't you?
Oh, yeah. Some good shit. But, I don't really like, the sort of winey, vinegary sours.
Right.
Like the reserves and whatever they are. Health. 2 pips. Plenty of health. Let's do this. Now that I have a shotgun. Ah, shit, they have wolves. Not even gonna. Shotgun is for wolf. Shit. Get wrecked.
Yeah, this is the most epic slideshow I've ever seen.
Yeah. I swear, Inside it was working base. When I started up the game, and then I accidentally tapped out and fucking...
Yeah, which, it's still fine. I can understand what's going on. It's just like kind of watching a PowerPoint presentation right now. Inside baseball, Mitch is in Reno, Nevada. I'm in Rochester, New York. We get video feeds through Google Hangouts. Thanks, guys. Great work. Keep it up. Don't change a damn thing.
I mean, it's not really Hangout. It's not Google Hangouts. It's OBS. Also, I don't know if it counts as Inside Baseball anymore because we say it, like, every time we do anything.
That's kind of true.
I do love fighting these cat guys, though. The way they move is like the way I move, and it works they really need their well.
Own, they need their own game.
Yeah, they're like half the enemies in this game, at least, maybe not half, but a lot of the enemies in this game look like basically rejected designs for the protagonist. Let's see. Oh, sweet, yes. Sweet life, yes.
On board.
Yeah, these guys have a dash that they, like, have a startup on, and it's just really satisfying to dodge. And then sometimes they can actually aw, shit. Bad call. Get Zelda'd. They can dodge my shots. Getting too style. Too flash. Direct. 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 Alright. I should find something else to say other than get wrecked.
It's such a universal saying at this point that it's okay. Like get wrecked or it's a little bit safer in certain environments to say than like get fucked or something.
Yeah. I'm gonna lick these pussies.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah. Get licked.
Yeah, they're cat-ish guys. Cat-like. No. I'm not even fucking around with the dogs right now. Oh gosh.
Oh, doggos. Ugh. Bubble I just swallowed just came right back up. I did that right into the mic. Sorry about that, hungry ones.
Perfect.
Dude, oh, hey. You are.
Oh, wait. A door. Yes, and I can open it. Oh, yeah. Oh, happy day.
You are on top of shit today, man.
Yeah. Oh, fuck me. Oh, you son of a bitch. Door. Door, you fucked me. You lied to me, door. How can you do this to me?
That escalated immediately.
Oh. Door opened a path. Path opened a bog. Bog was in a bird. Bird was in a tree. Tree was in a branch. Whoa, the rattling bog. Bog near him, Dan and Barrow.
What the fuck are you talking about?
You ever listen to Authority Zero?
Can't say as I have.
That's okay. They're from, like, Southern California. They were a sort of popular pop punk band for, like, a minute.
The name sounds familiar, yeah, but I don't think that it really made its way to my market.
Look at how that just fucking, like... That's so clinical, the way it murders those guys.
I was gonna say, was that, like, giblets that I just saw?
Probably, yeah. It's like... It's like slaughtering a cow. You just put it right up against their forehead and pop. Oh, is this gonna be? Is this gonna be? Oh, it's another key.
Oh.
God damn it!
What did you think it was?
I swear, behind some of these, like, locked doors, there's, guns.
Oh, yeah.
And they're essentially the same as the guns you already have, but they're better versions. And I keep like hoping the hand to get cannon. One. Yeah. Excuse me. A little sniffly here. I've also learned to drink my beer with my right hand so I can keep moving in the game. We're getting this fucking Let's Play thing down. Flush.
Damn right.
How could you do this to me? I could just sneak up on like me, this, like this. Dishonorable. I thought you were a cat.
You can
eat. Not a pussy. Yeah.
Cats having honor. God, you're fucking hilarious.
But they're like samurai pizza cats. They deliver 30 minutes or less every time, or it's free.
I love the 90s so fucking much.
There's so much that's, like, so beautiful about that show. The fact that, you know, they had a Paul Lynde sound-alike for no goddamn reason. Just, yeah, we'll make the announcer sound like Paul Lynde, and, like, it's so needlessly weird. Like, on top of already being a weird show, the American dub is so just utterly strange. So this is the boss door.
And, yeah, we're actually gonna hold off on that for right now. Because I do have to close the 90s style arcade, complete with all these, like, shit. Neons and pastels and shit like that.
Yeah, the fucking 90s color scheme in this forest.
That is exactly what this- it's like those fucking, the paper cups from the 90s.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, there's like a whole meme, like, there's a subculture associated with just that one pattern. And just that one color scheme of, like, the sort of purplish blue and, like, the teal or whatever it was.
Yeah, like the fucking, it's the Charlotte Hornets colors.
Yeah. Just that weird, those two paint stripes, people put them on everything now.
And I believe it's called, the pattern itself is called Jazz. I think they actually found out, like, the designer that made that pattern.
Yeah, yeah, there's, like, records, there's articles somewhere on the internet about it. It's insane. It's kind of beautiful in its weirdness. People will obsess over anything in this day and age.
God bless the internet.
Yeah.
So if you guys like what you see, leave us a comment down below and let us know how you're doing, how we're doing, how much you like jazz from the 90s, how much... If you ever had those paper cups, are the shit. Follow us on social media at Quarter Munchers and on Twitch at @Quarter_Munchers. Till then, I am Johnny.
I am the only man.
And the arcade is closed. Jazz hands.